exactly is Dendrobium Extract? Now, you've seen Dendrobium everywhere. You've seen it in crazed, tons of products are carrying Dendrobium now. And probably like, what the heck is Dendrobium? Because I know Dendrobium's a plant, but why is it in a supplement? You've seen it in crazed. Now they've got it in Jay Cutler's new ProStim. You've seen it in BPI before. Gaspari had one called Detonate. And you're seeing it in a lot more supplements. What the heck is it? I'm gonna tell you. When I mention the word Dendrobium, there's probably a couple bells that have rung among a lot of people. Hey, Dendrobium, isn't that the crap that was in Craze? And isn't Craze banned? Aren't they in a legal lawsuit? Yes, they had a huge lawsuit against them. It's widely known. It's no secret. This is what happened. And this kind of is like a prelude into exactly what Dendrobium is, because there's a huge misconception about Dendrobium. Most people think Dendrobium is freaking evil. It was in Craze, so that makes it like completely bad and illegal and wrong. So let me get into it, okay? Give me a second. Two athletes were banned from international competitions after they failed the anti-doping tests by WADA, right? It was like the World Anti-Doping Association or something like that, right? And because these two athletes failed these tests, it prompted Harvard University, a lot of Asian scientists, actually a lot of people to actually test Craze. These companies, these universities actually went out and bought a couple bottles of Craze, and they did a very scrutinizing, very detailed test on Craze to find out what was in Craze that made these guys fail this test. What they found was 21 to 35 milligrams per serving of a stimulant called N-alpha-DEPEA. And this ingredient is actually considered an amphetamine-like substance. It's got the same similarities as the same effects as methamphetamines, causing failed drug tests. Dendrobium has many alkaloids, but the problem is, because they've used dendrobium in Chinese medicine for thousands of years, dendrobium is you can buy a plant, obviously you know that. But here's the problem. They feel like this stimulant, N-alpha-DEPEA, was an ingredient that they used to spike dendrobium, basically saying it was something that wasn't naturally found in dendrobium. So enough of that bullcrap, right? I wanted to just get that out of the way. So what exactly is it, man? Get to the meat and potatoes, all right? Now, dendrobium, again, has been used for thousands of years in Chinese traditional medicine to help with asthma. That's right, they use it for treatment for asthma. So using dendrobium might actually help bronchodilate your lungs, meaning you're going to breathe a lot easier or better in the gym or during whatever physical exercise or activity that you're doing. It's very close, has a very close origin to ephedrine. They're using it as a replacement for ephedrine. Companies are using it as a replacement for 1,3-DMAA. That is why you're seeing a lot of it, is because 1,3-DMAA, you know, there's a lot of, basically no one wants to carry it anymore. The government's like cracking down this ingredient. They're like, what the heck is going to be better than this? That's why they're busting out dendrobium. Obviously, you don't see Craze anymore. You don't see Gaspari Detonate, because they actually found that kind of sketchy stimulant in Detonate as well. I think actually the makers of Craze are the guys that make Gaspari Detonate, and that's why they found that in both those two products. What you're gonna find are very strong stimulant-like effects. You're basically speaking in everyday street corner vernacular, you're gonna be jacked up on this ingredient. Tons of energy, and you're gonna have strong sensory effects. Sensory meaning you are gonna be focused, like laser beam, freaking telescope, microscope, whatever, focus. It's gonna give you tons of energy, obviously. It's gonna help you burn fat, and again, focus, big time focus. There are several dendrobium extract alkaloids, and that's really where you're breaking down all these different pieces of dendrobium. Let's start with the top one. That's dendrobine. It raises your blood sugar moderately, so you're gonna get some energy just by having a raise in blood sugar, and it decreases your blood pressure. Then you have B-phenylethylamine, which is gonna give you weight loss. and just more energy. Dendroxin, which is something that's gonna increase brain function. So that's something that's gonna give you that focus, that's gonna give you basically the ability to cast away distractions and focus on the task at hand. Dendromine. Dendromine is something that's gonna help with your brain. Again, it actually fights neurological damage or neuro damage from brain toxins that attack the brain. So you're probably not gonna see like immediate results or immediate effects from dendromine. And the last alkaloid is N,N-dimethyl-B-phenylethylamine. This is gonna give you hardcore stimulant effects, focus, and a sense of well-being. Isn't that just lovely? Just this good sense of well-being goes such a long way in the gym, now doesn't it? Here's my thing. Here's what I wanna let you guys know. You know, it goes with any supplement, man. I mean, you know, if you got a supplement and it's telling you it's gonna give you, you know, stimulants in it, it's gonna give you total energy and you're gonna just be totally rushed on it. People have been talking about it. It's gonna give you the focus. Guys, be smart about it. Be safe about it. Be wise about it, okay? Again, use some wisdom, man. If they've been talking about it and people are saying, hey, this stuff's gonna light you up. Dude, maybe you might not wanna start with one scoop. Maybe you need to drop your ego a little bit, use some common sense, and you have half a scoop. Just kind of get used to it, see if it's for you. You might take one scoop and be in hell, bro. You might take it and have a dang anxiety attack, vomit, and just be in, let's just say, utter discomfort, not so much in a sense of well-being, right? So again, use some wisdom. So there you have it, man. That's what dendrobium extract is. Again, when you're taking this ingredient, be careful, assess your tolerance. Hopefully you learned something here, and I kind of dispelled a little bit of false information out there. Don't forget to subscribe, guys. Please give me a like and tune in next time. See ya.